Hi, I'm Rick Emerson, and welcome back to Outlook Portland on Northwest 32 TV. We are here with Mr. Willy Vlautin. He's the author of books such as The Motel Life, North Line, and Lean on Pete, also the lead singer, songwriter for the band Richmond Fontaine. We talked about growing up, and you said the music and books and movies were your best friends, that they were sort of an escape or a refuge. What was the first book that made a serious impact on you, a significant impact?
I mean, I guess the one that made me want to write was Cannery Row, John Steinbeck. I really admired him. I mean, I grew up reading, like, Ian Fleming's novels really got me. I just read what was around the house. My mom loved, you know, mysteries and spy novels, but it was John Steinbeck that really meant something to me as a kid, and the other guy that made me actually start writing was Raymond Carver. When I was 20, I read Carver, and I felt like he was the first guy that was telling stories that I really understood, and in a way I understood, and I thought I really wanted to do that, and I was really inspired by him. And so I started writing stories pretty obsessively from, say, 20 on.
Was there a specific moment or an instant when you decided consciously that you were going to attempt to write?
Yeah, when I, you know, there was a book, a collection of stories of his called Where I'm Calling From. And at the time I was living in the garage of this girl I was dating's parents' house. And I was living a Raymond Carver story. And I was really moved, and I liked the work ethic of writing, I always have. And so when I read him, I finally figured out that you don't have to be the smartest guy in the world. You don't have to go to Stanford or Harvard. You just have to tell a story with blood, with heart, and practice at it. And so it was reading him then that made me, from a week after that, I was just cranking stories out.
Was it the language and the style, the approach he used of sort of nuts and bolts ethic in his writing, or was it the people and situations he wrote about that captured you?
I mean, first, you're not intimidated by him when you first read him because it's so simple. I mean, obviously, you start learning how hard that is, but it was the simplicity of it, and I understood those guys. It was like I always say, like a drunk uncle whispering your life story in your ear, like it's some bad party. And so I understood all those stories and those people, and Carver's men were just kind of hanging on by a thread. And I understood that. I understood that story, and I felt like I wanted to tell my version of that. So I was really inspired by him.
A lot of the guy you just described, the guy who was just hanging on to life by his fingernails, you know, the man who's been painted into a corner, who's desperate, who's at loose ends, a lot of those same figures are in your writing as well as in your songwriting. Was that a conscious choice, or is that who you see when you look at the blank page? Is that just what appears to you?
No, I mean, I think it's just because I'm there. I mean, I just write those things because that's where I feel I am. You know, I polarize them and make it more dramatic. But that's, you know, it's like when you hear a song and you get very emotional about it and you feel very dramatic, that's the way I write, you know. But basically, I'm just those guys trying to hang on and writing just as a way you can look at things that scare you or you're trying to figure out and you can control them. It's the only time in life you can control anything. You can kill anybody you want. You can marry anybody you want and make as much or little money as you want in a story, but you can control it.
Tell me a little bit about your writing process. Do you have a schedule by which you write, or do you wait for the idea to strike you and then sit down?
I mean, really, it's just I look at writing as a luxury. I mean, it's a great gift to get around, to sit around and get to write when most guys are working really hard jobs or monotonous jobs or whatever. And so anytime I can write, I will. You know, I mean, life gets in the way or other stuff gets in your way. But so I'm not one of those guys. Like my great hero, William Kennedy, who's one of my favorite all-time writers, says you have to write every day, even on your birthday and Christmas. And I'm just not that type of guy, you know, but it, to me, it's my favorite thing to do. So I do it any chance I can.
When you look at the other guys in those warehouses and other jobs you've had, do you feel like that would have been you if you hadn't discovered music or writing?
It might be me in a few years, you never know. It's just in the last couple of years I don't drive by warehouses and get depressed, you know. You'll see them and just go, oh, I'm so glad I don't work there. But I mean, the greatest thing that ever happened to me was I became a house painter. I know it sounds horrible, you know, like, wow, what kind of guy? But for me, that was like where I first started making decent money and could be my own boss. And I started writing in the morning before I went into work. And my life changed around. When most guys, you know, get out of prison, they become house painters. But for me, it was a great step up.
We're talking to Mr. Willy Vlautin. You stay right there. We will continue right after this on Outlook Portland. You're watching Northwest 32 TV. Don't go anywhere.